So let's talk about phishing. I recently asked MacMost users to send me examples of phishing attacks that appear to come from Apple. This is a particular problem for Apple users. Phishing attacks can come from anywhere. They can appear to come from your bank. They can appear to come from Amazon or eBay. But for Apple users, we get a lot of them that appear to come from Apple. They target us because we have iCloud accounts, or maybe they're just targeting everybody and you just happen to be somebody who has a Mac and got one of these. Let's take a look at some of them. So here's one that appears to tell you that you've been locked out of your iCloud account and you have to do something to get back in. And you can see here there's a link that looks like an official link to go and unlock your account. But the thing about phishing attacks is the links always appear to be official. But links can be disguised very easily. So this link here won't actually take you to apple.com, but probably will take you to a site that looks like apple.com, at least the login page. And then you're going to enter your Apple ID and password into that login page. And now you've given your password to some sort of malicious individual or organization. It may then even try to disguise the fact that you've done that, but maybe giving you an error message and jumping to the actual Apple site where you can go on and think maybe nothing has gone wrong. Here's another one. A lot of these some sort of urgent thing going on. Here in this case, it's somebody else is trying to get into your account and requested a change to your account. And it makes you a little bit panicked. And then there's a link right there, unlock my account. And of course that's not going to take you to the Apple site either. Here's another one. And notice all these seem to come from Apple or something to do with Apple. You can't trust the from line either. You can change your name to Apple and send email and people would get the email and look like it comes from Apple because you see a name, not the email address there. And even the from email address itself can be faked. So it can appear to come from something at apple.com and it actually doesn't. It's kind of like writing the return address on a letter. You can write anything you want there and stick it in the mail. It doesn't mean it's right, but anybody trying to scam you doesn't care what's right. So in this case, it tells you your account's been restricted. Maybe it even gives you your Apple ID. So it's going to send these out to iCloud accounts and it's going to put your real iCloud Apple ID in there maybe to make you think it's more authentic. And then you've got some links there and those links are no good. So a lot of these, of course, they try to play on your emotions. So here's something you've got that's telling you your payment was declined. Why? Is there something wrong with my credit card? Is there something going on? And it may make you rush to go and find out what's going on and maybe click on this link here. And look how official this email looks. It's got the Apple logo at the top, the Apple logo at the bottom. It says Apple support. And there's a lot of funny things in these different emails. Misspellings and things that obviously Apple wouldn't put in real emails. But a lot of times they look pretty official and it's hard to spot any imperfections. So of course you click on this link and it's not going to take you to appleid.apple.com. It's going to take you somewhere else. Maybe someplace that looks like it. Here's another one that plays on your emotion. A system alert fraud order. And look at the bottom half of this. You know, it looks like you've paid some money for something and you know, it wants you to sign in to take care of it. It's a pretty unofficial looking email, so it's hard to be caught by this one. But you may be so passionate about wanting to protect your account that you may tap sign in without thinking about it. Here's another one telling you that, you know, this is basically just a receipt. And in this case, it's not asking you to click on a link. It's asking you to open an attachment. And the attachment could be malware, could be adware, could be anything. So never open an attachment for something that you get in email. You can see right there, link to a PDF. You'll be prompted to open or view the file or download to your computer. For the best results, save the file first and open it in a web browser. So you can see right here, lots of alarms should be going off when seeing something like this. Now here's another one, and this one really tries to play on your emotions by putting a huge number there saying you've been charged $420,000, although there's missing a zero there because you made a purchase. And this is just kind of a courtesy notice from Apple and it looks a lot like a real one. So you may want to click on one of those links to go and figure out what's going on, and of course they are bad links. Now if you don't believe me how easy these things are to fake, here I've composed an email that looks kind of like the last one we just saw. I could easily insert a graphic at the top, just put a logo there, and I could easily fake the link. So here is a link right there. I can control click on it and say add a link. And then look what I can do with the link. I can make it look like an Apple link even if you check it. So maybe let's put security.apple.com, right? But that doesn't do me any good because if I'm a scammer, I don't own apple.com. But I keep going, .example.com. And what this is really going to do is it's going to take you to the website example.com, which has been configured to redirect anything going security.apple.com, .example.com to a malicious page that looks just like an Apple page and fakes having you log in just to capture your password. And when I send this, I get it here in as a message. And I can see here I got the link. And one way you can protect yourself against these kind of things is if you move your cursor over the link, you can see in mail it shows you the URL. But you have to be smart enough to recognize that this really goes to example.com because it's the end of the domain name, not the beginning, that counts. And that this is really fake. The best thing to do is never click on any of these links in any of these emails, no matter how official it looks, and instead go on to the site yourself. So if it tells you to go check your Apple ID, go type in appleid.apple.com in your web browser and go to it. If it tells you to check your iTunes account, check iTunes in the iTunes app. Do everything by going to your own bookmarks and typing your own links, not using the links in the email.